you can do better than that. You can clap harder than that. Okay. Welcome to Ronnie's Cross Club. Just a couple of quick reminders before we begin. Please ensure that your phones are switched off to silence and do keep your conversations to a minimum during tonight's performances. And also, no formal photography is allowed at the club. Now, all that out of the way, please put your hands together for Deodato!
Thank you. Thank you. Song that we want to present you is called the Whistle Bump. No, no, bump. Whatever it is, it's always a good song. I did that right to my Jews, Jim, from the radio station. He's a great guy. I keep forgetting the conversation that we had, but he told me this was in the Guinness World Records. They played in the radio stations in England. Strange, you know. In those days, I think the disco movement was a pretty big hit, since a lot of it. And it's not the one that gave me the... It was before the one they gave me a title as the king of the... What? Acid jazz. Sulfuric acid or something. Imagine if you drink that stuff. What happened to your stomach? No, thank you. But it's a cute song, and we'll try to present it to you as it should be. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
slightly different. The accents. I have to, no doubt, introduce the guys to you. These are incredible people. And you, to say that, that this is, I don't know what you called, but in the days that I did it, it was glass Brazilian involved, it was bossa involved, all kinds of stuff involved. But I called it jazz for fun. Yeah? Thank you. So much that I had a song that I wrote when I was the director for MC. It was called Funk Yourself. I'm serious. It was a good one too. Yeah, it's very danceable. It's a very danceable thing. I mean, one of those, there's a song that I have, it's called September 13th. You know why? Because it was September 13th. It just ran out of the idea for title. What are you doing? You better, hey, you're gonna need a title now to put it in the record. I say, well, what day is today? Okay, you got it.
That's my birthday.
There you go. Good. Good. So it was in your honor. At least one person that was born with something.
Oh, thank you.
See, I was thinking of you when I put it down. Okay, man, thank you. The guys are fantastic. I'm going to start with a percussion player, good friend, a guy who has played with me before. His name is Snowboy. I'm a drummer, what can I say? He did something tonight that I didn't know he was capable of doing. Oh, you're hiding your game, huh? You don't gamble, right? So why your name is Adam Betts? Our bass tonight on a special presentation because he had to cancel a big gig to come here tonight. His name is John Calvert. On the horns, which is very, very special to me because they did a very good job today and every time. Alto flute, alto saxophone and the flute, rather, is Graeme BLEVINS. The sax alto solo in Whirlwinds, it's got a very peculiar sound, which is very good. Yes, it does. You know, I know him. Don't look at me. He's played. I've been here many times before. He's played with me. Right? That's true. So it's not, I'm not putting a sugar in the cake. But on the baritone flute is Michael Lazurgi. Is new to me. We played a couple of days. Trumpet is Tom Glover. Trombone, old buddy, Dave Williamson. And guitar, very, very important person because plays the funk that most people don't know how to do. He's got his own thing. I'm serious. Al Cherry.
And ladies and gentlemen, the legendary Eumir Deodato.
Let's talk about it. I have an option. was an arranger. Name a person that you think I did not work and I'll tell you if I did. I did ghost arrangements for Quincy Jones when he was still living in New York at Universal. No, nothing wrong. When you have a pressure, you have to get farm it, I suppose. Lalo Schifrin, no, never worked with him because he always lived in California. Quincy Jones lived in there, in New York. Rachel, no, I wish I had. Such a good singer, like my favorite. No, from Europe. French, let's say, but chansonnier, very good. Charles Aznavour, yes. I did a record with him a couple of years ago. I did arrangements. It's difficult to work with because he's getting a little older, and he's all his material is based on words. It's just on your but I'll give you some name that you know, for instance. Professor Roberto Fleck. Yeah? For instance, Frank Sinatra. Yeah, I did. A whole record. He's a nice guy, but anyways. But he didn't. Who? Lyle? Didn't get that one. Oh, Miles Davis. No, I did not. A friend of mine did a lot of arranging with him. His name is Jason Miles. Did a lot of arranging. And of course, the bass player was the producer for his name. No. Did I work with Jaco Pastorius? Thanks God, no. No, I'm talking about the producer that produced the. His name? Miles Davis. A couple of records. I also produced a couple of singers. Very good. But as far as bass, I was auditioning for bass. And he's a good player, but I don't think he was good for the
Bill Ramone.
Who?
Bill Ramone.
Oh, yeah, friend of mine.
Great man.
When he was alive, he's not alive anymore. he's a few or more, sure. He had a studio on 45. Yeah, I always recorded there.
And
I did such as Astrid Gilbert.
No.
Records is growing, but it's close to 500 records. If I go back to Brazil, it was but anyway, this is a different story. But you provoked it. Okay, 2001 is the one that really made me known. I was laughing when I did. It was a great track. I heard it was good. And I had introduced new people to Quintet, such as Stanley Clark, who's the bass player. And acoustic bass. Get it or forget my name, seriously. Now, there was Ron Carter. 2001 had two bass players. Ron Carter was his big rag acoustic bass with an extension on the thick core of the string, which he tuned it to C. And Stanley Clark doing all of the work for him. He was an interesting track. But that's it. I'll see you guys soon.
Thank you.
One more time for Deodato and his band. Great band. Yes, there will be more, but tomorrow. Okay, folks, that's not the end of live music here at Ronnie Scott's. We're just going to take a short break, about half an hour or so, and we'll be right back with Fletcher's Brew. One more time for this fantastic band.